Hey everyone, Super Mario World. This game is a little older. I picked it up when I was a little older. Maybe, how old was I? Maybe like elementary school? Welcome to Isle Delfino. It looks like Bowser is at it again. Oh, well, who didn't know that was coming? Like, who didn't? Like, who? Maybe young children, they'll be like, oh my god, he's at it again! When will that turtle dude ever stop? Spoilers, he never does. Okay, how do I play? It shouldn't be too hard. Mario games just- oh, wow! They consist of usually just maybe like three buttons. Possibly a crouch if it's 3D. And that's that, right? Alright. Okay, well, we got it. Nice. Man, if I had paid attention to the calendar, I would have realized that Mario Day was a thing. And I didn't realize it was a thing until the day of, and I'm just like, okay. Oh, it's Mario Day. Oh, okay. I didn't do anything, but... what day was Mario Day again? I don't even remember. There it is. I guess, how serendipitous that I was able to put out a lot of Mario content before then. So I guess that counts. And I'll take it. I will keep it. Alright. This game's a classic. I like this game. It's a classic. Like, a modern classic? And I like to think so because of the music. The music in this game is, like, actually really good. I remember when I first learned that, what is up with him? Yeah, take the heat. What is it? Motifs. A motif, think of it as a melody, like a small melody. An example of a motif is Cass's theme from Breath of the Wild. So think of the main theme for The Legend of Zelda, and how, you know, it has like that main theme and stuff, and then how Cass's theme, if you listen to the whole thing, it has, you know, that Zelda theme in it. So that would be like an example of a motif. Or Luigi's Mansion. Literally the entire game has the same variations, no, not the same, but different variations of the same melody. Mario does that a kabillion times, and when I was little, as a child figuring this out, as a young musician, it absolutely blew my freaking mind. Made things a lot more easier to play. I'll continue and sing. You know what, why not? It's a one-up. I wanted to grace you all with a good Mario game and a longer video because Yoshi's Island is just giving me the blues. The blues, I say! Oh shit, I didn't mean to do that. No, I don't know. I'll just make some money. Yeah. Music is... oh wow, look at him. It looks like a seal. Music is just an awesome thing in general. Music, when you play an instrument, that is the only time you activate your entire brain. Did you know that? Fun facts. This game's a sham. They say Yoshi can eat anything, but he can't eat these charging dudes. I call shenanigans untrue. Not cool. Whatever. Oh, I also like how Yoshi's signature instrument are drums. In literally every game. Like, every game, there's just some drums added to his name. It's just a drummer boy. Yoshi with a snare drum. That'd be cute. Yoshi can barely play the snare drum, it'd be funny. It's like a little T-Rex. This game carries a lot of motifs too. Same melody, different variation, based on the area. Clever, classic. I don't know if it's lazy or genius. It's both. The same thing happens in Undertale. This isn't old news. People do this all the time. You just have to actually pay attention. Which is why whenever I play a new Pokemon game, I'm just like, oh my god, I gotta listen to this music. Is this like, is the music a reference or is the music original? I'll never know! And then I become obsessed and then I realize that, you know what, maybe I don't play enough Pokemon games to recognize this piece, but whatever. Which is true! Remember when I did that Pokemon LP? That was like a kabillion years ago. I can't believe I did that. Wow. I can't believe I did that. But anyways. Pokemon Emerald. I played the original Blue. And I played a little bit of Diamond and Pearl, but I didn't finish it. And then there was another. I played most of the newer ones, like X and Y, XYZ, Aloha Pokemon, or Alola Pokemon, for them. And the remake of Pokemon Emerald, and then wasn't there another one after it? I can't remember. I did it. Oh, duh! The most controversial Pokemon game, Sword and Shield. How could I have forgotten? Well, I forgot, but it's fine. Get over it. And so, I didn't really play all the other games in between. Was it like Diamond and Pearl and Black and White? Not because I didn't- well, actually it was because I didn't want to. I was slightly older than the friends that introduced it to me, and I kinda got over it. I was just like, hey, I'm over my Pokemon phase. You know, they're just gonna do nothing but add more Pokemon and more Pokemon games, and then they're just never gonna stop making Pokemon. It's gonna be infinite, and then it's just gonna be no point in trying to keep up with it all. And I was almost right. But, oh Jesus, the lag! Look at that. Get out of the water. Wait, can we get out? We kind of messed this up. Alright, there we go. God, this is like the world's longest start. Ah, the lag, please. Please and thank you. And we've done it. This is one of my favorite Mario games with my favorite music. It's just really good. There's a remix of this song in Super Smash Bros. Brawl, and this is like one of my favorite castle themes, and when I first heard the remix, I like shit my pants. Just a little kid, it's just like, oh my god! I don't know if other musicians do this, but I do this thing where, whenever I hear a song, what is it called, like an eargasm, and I'm just like, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, I'm like so in it. Yeah, I don't know, I'm weird like that, but I hope I'm not alone, because, you know, music makes you feel things that you can't express or explain. Or put into words. It's just like when you see beautiful art, you just can't put it into words. You can only put it into like grunts and expressions, like exaggerated expressions, and it's like obnoxious and annoying. But learning like the different motifs in music and remixes and video games honestly was a huge thing for me, and it still is. Get out of here. Yeah, when I was playing No Straight Roads and I was hearing the music for the first time, I was just like, oh my god, this is really groovy. This is grooving music. I love it. And then we got to Eve. Eve is my all-time favorite. Worst boss battle ever, I swear to god. Mario's defeated the demented Iggy. Oh, sad. The Donut Land. Donut Land has good music too. We're just gonna talk about music this entire flippin' episode. And I'm not sorry about it. Music is pretty neat. Without it, the world would not be round. continue it safe, sure. Eve's music was so good. Every time I hear it, I'm just like, and yeah, that's kind of what happens. Rude. Yeah, I'm kind of not playing the game the way it's supposed to. I'm just kind of running through it because I can. It's like, what is it? Oh, there we go. Cool. Secret. Can I? Nope. Do I know the secret? Yes, I did it! Do I know that? No. Hello? No. Hello? Fuck. Okay. That's fine. It's fine! It's fine. Okay. Sayu has good music. I don't know, that whole fucking game is like fucking great music. I love it so much. Love that game. I wanna do more with that game. But I wanna get out of here! Get me out of here, please. Get out of here. There we go. Anyways. Good music. Good music. Is a good time. That is all. No! I wanna keep this man. I kept the man. Good for us. Did everyone have a good Mario day? I feel kinda bad that like I just was like aloof. Ooh! I like this music, especially with the added drums because of Yoshi. Dang it. There's like a special way to time it. I tried to listen to the music, but the TV's on low, so it won't pick up in the mic. And that is that on that. But it picks up pretty loud in the capture card. The capture card is just like, oh my god, it's blaring even when the volume is at its lowest. I will have you know that this music literally means nothing. This song is so bland and not worth listening to without Yoshi. The drums make everything in this piece. Let me think. In other news... We're almost done with Yoshi's Island, so I have plans for the future, kind of low-key. Gotta figure out what I'm gonna do next. I have an idea of what I wanna do next. Please come back. I literally can't do any of this without you. And when that happens, it'll be like maybe like a week or two in between so I can prepare. And be like, yay! I'm ready to record again because I need to. I would like to. I like recording. Oh, be careful! Oh, be careful! This is important. This is important. Ta-da! This is like one of my favorite things. Finding secrets. This game is notorious for all these secrets, all these stupid secrets. They're so good. My friends and I have played this game. It's like all we would do would just be like, oh my god, did you find like the fucking secret? Oh shit, oh no! Hello? Come back! It's literally not even worth it if you're not here. No! You can die in here? Oh, you learn something new every freaking day, don't you? No, I usually don't get this far without this. I'm over it. I'm like kind of sad now. You know what would be a good game to play? Luigi's Mansion. That's a good one. That's a classic. It was the very first game I got for my GameCube for my 9th birthday. One of the major highlights. Got like the Sonic Heroes and Sonic DX. And then I also got Luigi's Mansion. Technically, Luigi's Mansion was the first. And then the Sonic games came like later. I played Luigi's Mansion first. Yeah! And the reason why I got Sonic Adventure or Sonic Adventure DX, like the director's cut, that god awful game that is also like really nostalgic and awesome just because it's old and bad. My good, I can't do anything here. Fuck! Wow! You were supposed to kill a man, but I was the man that got killed. Rude. Yeah, they have it for 3DS. I kinda wish that they had Luigi's Mansion ported to- My god, I can't catch a break, everyone. This is not my Mario Day. It's because it's not Mario Day. For the Switch, that would've been nice. But I understand, can't always port all the games to like the newest consoles just because. But then at the same time, I'm just kind of like, but I know there are a lot of good ones from the GameCube that got neglected. And I wish I could play with them because I have my- I actually still have my GameCube, but a lot of my games kind of mysteriously disappeared for reasons I don't care to go into. No, I won't do it. Give me the feather, or... No. Yeah, the feather. Can I live? Please, like, please and thank you. So, kind of being bullied and I don't appreciate it. Being bullied is like no bueno. Everyone's been bullied at least at some point. And if you haven't been bullied, consider yourself really lucky. It's an experience that kind of sticks with you, regardless of how old you are, because being bullied as a kid can mess things up for you. And then being bullied as an adult is just so stupid. It's rude. And it's like, aren't we all supposed to be mature here? We're adults, right? Wrong. They only look like adults. There, I said it. And besides, when you get bullied as an adult, you can like seriously get bullied like over like serious issues, and then that's not cool. It's not nice. It's not fun. It's just not nice. Everyone, just be kind. Anyways, are we done with this level? I hate levels like this. This is the one thing that I can't stand. Side-scrolling levels. The bane of everyone's existence. Nobody likes it. Yeah, I don't like it. Oh, you know, that reminds me. Had a birthday recently, and I got like this email from Nintendo. I linked in my accounts. And, whoa, God, these stupid ghosts, they're just so goofy. Yeah. Really interesting. I got screen cheat. I think I talked about this once. Can't remember. But yeah. It was just so neat. Okay, what do I do here? There we go. Too bad I don't have the feather. Oh god, what goes in here? Shit, I'm not doing this right. Aw, man. Could you all turn to stone, please? I don't know what to do, I don't remember. I don't remember. I actually don't remember. It's been a while. It's been that long that I actually forgot. Good for me, that's kind of cool. Do I take this with me? No, I can't take anything with me. What the fuck? What happened? What's going on? I don't understand. I don't know what's going on. I don't remember. I got out. I got out. Got out the house. I got out the crazy house. Dude, ghosts are scary. Don't fuck with ghosts and they won't fuck with you, I think. Or, yeah. Not sure. Yeah, we'll do a few more and then we'll call it a life to make it extra long. Cause I feel really bad when I don't get my videos out on time. It's usually when I try to record ahead, I'm just like, things in life kinda mess things up sometimes. And then it's just like, oh, that's right, I gotta do this thing, and then this thing is a thing, and I'm like, oh, I'm tired of all these things happening. Oh well. Let's call it life. Let's call it the definition of being an adult. Adjusting to inconveniences and running errands for the rest of your life. And working. Yeah, that too. It's kind of a drag, but only if you make it a drag, I think. Remember, I was talking to my buddy Trevon, and how I'm trying to get through Persona 4 Golden, and I watched this one video about how this dude's view on Persona 4 and how it changed his life, and I'm just like, can games really change your life? And you know what? Yes, they can. They've changed mine. My mother is slowly... She's become way more accepting of this kind of stuff, like games and music in games, and I don't know, she likes it. She's just like, I'm glad that she's able to appreciate that games are just more than mind-numbing material and entertainment. But the fact of the matter is, oh man, this pissed me off as a child. I'm like, the castle is literally right there. But once you like get behind like the meaning of Persona 4 Golden, basically you have like all these stats and you try to better your stats, right? Because you want to be better, but it's like more than just how your stats affect you in battle. It's like how your interpersonal relationships with your friends. Oh, a moon. That's cool. And you just want to better yourself every single day. Like, you do your homework, you get smarter, you get a job, you make money, like a little job, like folding envelopes. I would totally get a job of folding envelopes. I would fold envelopes all the ding dong day. I would listen to audiobooks. I would, you know, have music playing. I would watch the YouTube. I would go to streams. I would do so much if I could just sit there and fold some envelopes, but that's not really it. It's not really jobs anymore. But anyways, like just shit to do in the spare time. Oh god, dry bones. Spooky. Spreaky. That's a word. I hope it's not a bad word that I don't know about. Hate it when I say a word and it winds up being bad and I'm like, oh sh- I just didn't know. Yeah, and so every time I want to play Persona 4 Golden, I want to focus on the theme of the game by bettering yourself. And so every time I pick it up, I'm just like, it's a game about bettering yourself. And I kind of want to do that in real life, not just the game. So I always put it down. And it's just so... It's so counterproductive. It's ruined my progress in the game to a point where I just literally had to start over. It's been so long since I played the game. It's like, I was the fool, but... I tried to, I don't know, be good about it. Oh shit, oh god, no! What have I done? Ugh, this will be my last castle. I've been going for a little while. And if I die one more time, it's over. Fuck! I guess it's over. I didn't mean to do that! It's over, it's fine, it's fine, it's fine, it's fine, it's fine. Happy late Mario Day, I guess. And expect more Yoshi's Island. Hopefully it won't give me any more problems. I'm gonna go listen to some music. And thank you for watching, and I will see you later.